Hello all, welcome to High Definition Television HDTV session. I am Varsha Kiran Patil from EC Department AISSMS IOIT, Pune. Let us have the session for HDTV. The overview of this session is HDTV advancements, block diagram, HDTV specifications. Then we will see the timeline, applications, current issue and hardware requirement of the HDTV. When we see the HDTV advancement, the start point of this is a VCR, that is video cassette recorders. Then came the laser disc LD. Then next process was digital versatile disc, which are called as DVD. From DVD, the advancement was compact disc, which was called as CD. And from CD, the technology turns to digital audio tapes, DAT, and then came the high definition HDTV. So this was the overall flow of the market that happened in recent years of 40 years that happened in the market. In case of HDTV, 60s was seen the Japanese Broadcasting Corporation, which is known as NHK. Many different formats were evolved in US. In 1993, FCC Alliance was formed. Also, the Grand Alliance formed in 2016. This was the timeline, or we can say that advancements in case of HDTV in the market of TVs. Next, we have to see the block diagram of HDTV. In case of HDTV, we have to take into consideration two particular forms, that is video signals and audio signals. And for that, we are getting the signals which are demodulated and demultiplexed. And we get that digital signal converted into video into audio signals. So these video signals and audio signals get decoded separately. And we get that HDTV in display format and decoded format. And we get the high definition television. So this is the block diagram of the HDTV. If we constrain upon the specifications of that particular PAL, CCAM and NTSC, we can find that these are the regions where PAL is seen: Asia, Europe, South America. In case of CCAM, it is in France, and in case of NTSC, it is in US. The channel bandwidth is varying 6 MHz for NTSC, and for PAL and CCAM, it is 8 MHz. In case of PAL and CCAM, aspect ratio is 4:3, whereas in case of NTSC, there is a version in which 16:9 HDTV is present in case of USA. The frame rates and vertical refresh rate and highest resolution comparison is given in this particular yellow table. So this is the comparison of specifications of HDTV variants occurring in different parts of world. Now let us turn about the what are the HDTV features. In case of features, if we see into a wider picture, we can have the higher resolution picture, we can have digital surround sound, we can have easy interface with computers, and this lead to IPTV, etc. And additional data we can get into consideration. We can have the extra channels for information services, music or internet services. HDTV has very important thing, that is 16:9 aspect ratio is there. Also we can have the 1080 interlaced scanning. Now in this case, we are having the feature that is nothing but HDTV is not compatible with digital line. HDTV signal is received through satellite dish or antenna. That is the important thing that is we have to take into consideration. And the normal feature of 30 frames seconds or 2 fields per frame that is occurring in case of HDTV. In case of HDTV, some of the information that we have to take into consideration is for the HDTV, 5:1 surround sound audio is there, and we do have a MPEG format. Video format span the large range of main level to higher level, and we do have a transport subsystem of MPEG-2 and packets consisting of 188 bytes. So this way we do have the MPEG-2 systems that is happening in the HDTV. This is the some more information related to that is technology used. In case of hardware requirement, what is required for HDTV? In case of HDTV, we require digital decoder. We require the HDTV set. Digital decoder converts the digital signals into analog signals and allow current TV to work. In case of HDTV set, we do have access of 18 digital input formats, and it makes us the digital TV ready TV set, widescreen format and progressive scanning instead of insertless scanning. What are the applications of HDTV? In case of HDTV, the applications are high definition experiences given to, that is enriched experience given to consumers. Also, it is useful for due to its high definition in medical purposes. In case of video on demand, in case of telemetry applications, in case of internet surfing and distance learning, all these applications or all those applications where high definition is required, there you can find the HDTV applications. What are the concluding remarks? Concluding remarks for the HDTV is that it is useful in modern life where we can have the normal picture which can be zoomed to 16:9 format, and it can have the MPEG-2 compression, and it can use instead of interlaced scanning to progressive scanning with wider screen. So we have seen HDTV in a different way, like applications, its technical specifications, where it is used, how what is the bandwidth and all other things related to high definition television systems. This is Varsha Kiran Pati signing off from this episode of HDTV. Thank you very much for watching.